Are you ready for some Procreate fun? Well, let's jump in! Hi and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Brenda Bakker and I'm from the Netherlands. I'm working on a series of the alphabet inspired by the book from Carla Kamphuis, Brush Lettering Alphabet for Everybody. And for today's video, I've chosen the cactus. And I've given it some lovely watercolor, and I will be drawing with my dry ink brush. I'm using Lisa Glanz's watercolor brush sets, and also a few of my own from my sketchy doodling class. You can find on Skillshare. A free link to Skillshare is is below this video, and let's get started. So for this letter H, I choose out of the book the cactus drawings of the cactus alphabet. So let's get started. I'm going to draw on my, I have to clear it out. I'm going to draw on my watercolor paper, which is free in my Skillshare classes. I don't share this with everybody because I think my students in class will have a little bit points up. So the watercolor canvas is provided for free in my Skillshare class, and if you want a free trial to Skillshare, please be welcome to click on the link below and it will get you to everything you need in my classes. And for this one I choose black, and I choose a dry ink brush, which you can find under inking. And let me see, I have the book nearby, but I can't show it to you because we don't want to give everything away what's in the book. But I can do some lettering for you. So I'm going to draw an H, like a cactus shape. So this will be my H, and the cactus will be around here somewhere. And this will be a little of my sketch. I think this can be a little bit from here. It can be a little bit more swingy, and also this can be a little bit more swingy also. So let's create a lovely vibrant shape out of it, maybe with some adjustments like so, a little bit. So I think this could be my sketch, and I make this opacity really low so I can still see a little bit of the shapes, and I'm going to draw for real on top of that. I'm going to do with my inking brushes, which will also have some pressure sensitivity, so I'm going to have to make some use of that. So I make my upstroke very thin with light pressure. I'm going to bend it and adjust some pressure next to it, so I think that would look lovely. And then it has some little bows in it with not a lot of pressure, but also not a little. And this one can be having a more of a pressure. So you will see automatically a shadow shape in here. And in between that, with even lighter pressure, some smaller strokes. Maybe you can also make this less hard. Well, this already looks very lovely, and I'm going to make it a little bit bigger again, but not too big, because I don't want to have it as hard as this one. And this one I think can be a little harder. So I think this looks like a lovely H. Get rid of the sketch, and now we're going to have some fun with some watercolors. And for that I'm going to use the Lisa Glanz watercolor set, because I think this is one of the best so far. I have two other sets which I also like. This is the aquarelle from Lisa Glanz that I'm going to use. I also like the set of the Big Wet Set by Matthew Baldwin, I think his name was. And Trailhead Design Go also have a lovely watercoloring set, but this is quite more a little bit my favorite. So I'm going to use the round brush all rounder, and for the cactus I'm going to use some green, grayish green, like here. I think yes, that would be lovely. And I'm always going to create a new layer for everything, and I want my watercolor below the line art, so that's where I create my new layer. So let me see how big the brush is. Yes, and I think I'm going to create some lovely shape. You see, my my watercolor is a little bit dark than the color of my choice. It's because of the watercolor blending in the paper, in the texture. So I'm going to make it slightly lighter. Let's get a little bit of yellowish green, I think. Maybe a little bit more yellow on here. Yeah, I like that. And I'm going to use the big wash in the smudge. And I'm going to smudge it again. A little bit, not going to smudge in away every detail of the watercolor because I like the bleeds, and also I don't mind if the bleed is also a little bit outside of the paper. And I think we can add a little bit of highlight on top of that, so I'm going to create white. And watercolor can't be opaque, so I'm going to my dry ink brush again, which I also have in my sketchy doodling class. So that's where it's on top. You see my favorites are all the way on top. So I create a light. Oh, perhaps I'm doing it all the way to the sides to make it more fun. And also a bit here to make it more exciting and not so hard, but very thin. This side must be thinner than the one I have here. So if this one is a little bit thicker, I make that one thicker also. Just make it makes more happening there, so that's why I choose this way. I think that looks nice. I'm going to play with some fine dots, which is also from my sketching doodling class. So if you've done that, you're in advanced. So let's make this a happy cactus. And we can make on top of that, go to our black. Now I'm going above the line art, create a new layer, because when I don't like it, I can also make adjustments. I choose in my fine tip and create some lovely spines on that. And you can create however you want. It's just for fun. There's no good, there's no bad, there's no right, there's no wrong. Just have fun. I think this looks lovely already. And perhaps I'm going to use some black dots again. Make them even more fine. I'm going to lose my voice. So just like every here and there. I want to make it more fun, so. I think we have a lovely cactus letter H. I hope you liked it. Thank you for watching this episode until the very end. If you like this video and think I've earned it, please give this video a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to this channel if you haven't already. More detailed tutorials can be found on Skillshare. These and all other links can be found in the description below. Thanks again for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!